All right, this first video on elasticity of demand, we want to explain what you're looking at in the graph. So we want you to understand what's being plotted here. And then we want to actually try to see if we can get to the economics of what elasticity means. So that's our two goals. Let's start by looking at these buttons. It says set the price intercept and set the quantity intercept for the linear demand curve. This downward sloping blue line is the demand curve, and let's raise the price intercept and see what happens. If I click on it, see it goes up. If I click on it the other way, it goes down. The intercept moves. This point doesn't change, but this point changes. I'm going to move it back to 100. Likewise, if I set the quantity intercept, if I click it, it moves to the right, and if I lower it, that intercept moves to the left. So you can change the demand curve by changing these two controls. These two controls set the demand curve. I'm going to leave for a moment what this purple unitary elastic curve is, and we'll get back to it in a little while. You have two other controls here. One is for the original price, which is now set at 30, and one is for the new price, which is also set at 30. Let's raise the new price. Okay, and as we raise the, now the original price becomes visible. I'm going to raise it a little bit more just so I can make everything visible and not overlap. There we go, and let's make it a nice round number. So let's move that new price to 50. Okay, and so we have a new price at 50, and we have the old price was at 30, and you can see the resulting quantities as a consequence of that. So let's now talk about this line, which is from the origin to the curve at this point, and we've got almost everything explained. So here's the idea behind elasticity. We want to know how many people in this region, which is the inframargin, the ones who are no longer buying at the higher price but were buying at the lower price, are relative to both the inframargin and the margin, the ones who are still buying plus the ones who dropped out. So we want to know the relative size of the margin, and so we look at this change, the new quantity minus the old quantity, and we look at it as a percentage of the original quantity. But obviously, this number is going to be bigger the price increase is. So we normalize by the percentage change in price. That's this difference by the original divided by the original price. So it's a percentage change in quantity divided by the percentage change in price. And with a little bit of algebra, what that turns out to be is P0 over Q0, which is the slope of this line from the origin to the curve, times the change in quantity over the change in price. Now, the slope of this line is the change in price over the change in quantity, so it's really the slope of this line from the origin to the curve divided by the slope of the line of the blue demand curve. That's what the elasticity is measuring, and at this particular point, it's giving the elasticity as minus 0.43. Now let's raise the original, actually let me lower the original price a little bit and we'll see what happens. The elasticity falls as I lower the original price even further. And if I raise the original price, the elasticity rises, and if I get it all the way to 50, look, it's going to rise to exactly 1, I believe. And then if I raise it beyond that, it gets to be above 1. So that's the sense of what's in this graph.